ओके जस्ट अ सेकेंड
नो प्रॉब्लम।
कैन यू सी द माय प्रेजेंटेशन हियर?
यस
या ओके सो अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू प्रेजेंट हियर and my name is Prachi Sharma and I am from department of electrical engineering indian institute of technology roorkee that is in india and the topic of today's presentation is deep models and optimizers for indian sign language recognition so first of all the contents just to give a glimpse so first one is the objective then we have the motivation of this work then the hyperparameters the optimizers deep models and the data set I have used for the ISL recognition I will be calling indian sign language as ISL here then the proposed methodology results then comparison with literature and then final conclusion so first of all the objective there will be three objectives achieved here first is the classification of static indian signs I have used only static signs and then the tuning of hyperparameter batch size and then the evaluation of four adaptive gradient based optimizers only and two pre-trained deep models and all these three have been done on indian sign language dataset that I have taken from literature Now the motivation. So for motivation, first of all, I have to define what is a sign language. Most of us know, but still, I just want to define it. So sign language is the language of deaf and mute community, and these people don't converse using sound patterns. They only use visual languages. That includes our hands, shoulder, facial expressions, and. So and this language is not very common still the community is very large but normal people don't understand this language so here are the statistics this is the whole world statistics by world federation of deaf and it is in 2009 there are around more than 72 million deaf people and that was in like 2009 and out of that 80% live in developing countries and as my work is on Indian sign language so here are the statistics from the census of India 2011 so there are around 26.8 million people disabled in India and out of that number that huge number 18.9% constitute deaf people and 7.5% constitute mute people so that is a huge community so our motivation is to just convert their language into some understandable language that is text or speech so moving on to the next part now start with the hyperparameters I have used in my work so these are the hyperparameters these are basically of two types model specific and optimization so what are hyperparameters basically the whole training process of a machine learning and deep learning models based on these hyperparameters so I am talking in terms of deep learning because I have used that in my work so there are two types first type is the model specific like the that deals with the architecture of the of a model like the number of hidden layers or the number of layers and the optimization which we can optimize like batch size learning rate number of epochs So in my work, although I have used only batch size to tune, I have shown here tuning only of batch size, and the range I have used is 8, 16, 32, 64, and 128. That is the range I have taken, and so batch size is basically the number of training samples you send in at a time to the model to train at a time. So. It has so much significance which we will be dealing in the further slides then learning rate decides the speed of the conversions to the desired convergence point that we want in our model. And I have taken it 0.00001, that is small, and usually it is like it should be kind of small. And I have taken a fixed number of epochs, 100 in this world. So now moving on to the next part, these are the hyperparameters I am using in my work. The next part is the optimizers in my work. So optimizers are really, as the name suggests, optimizer. They optimize any algorithm and they pave the way for the convergence point faster and efficiently. So in my work, I have used four types of optimizers, and that are adaptive gradient-based optimizers. So adaptive here means the optimizers that can learn on their own how to change and when to change the learning rate. So like starting from the first one came in 2011, that is EDAGRAD. It's the short form. It basically uses the data set characteristics. So the optimizer that is used before this model was stochastic gradient descent optimizer, and with momentum term. So that optimizer doesn't consider the model characteristic. That is a small, that is a very important part of any model. But this optimizer considers the characteristics of the model, data. So here, it actually divides the global learning rate by the squared gradients. So that's how it changes the learning rate throughout the training process by this term that is in the denominator, that is the squared gradients, accumulation, the sum of the squared gradients. But it has become adaptive. But the problem in this optimizer is that because the denominator term is very large, accumulation of gradients. So as the training progresses, the learning kind of stops because the gradients become very small. So there is no learning, no changes. So to solve this problem, this Ada Delta optimizer was developed in 2012, and it solves both the problems of Ada Delta. That is, problem one is monotonically decreasing learning rate that we have just told here, and the second one also. So for the first one, instead of using squared gradients, it used the average of running average of the past squared gradients, and to solve the second problem, it simply replaced the learning rate by an exponentially decaying average of parameter updates. So now we don't have to provide any learning rate to it. So it solves both the problem. Now the next one is the rules were developed by different people, but at the same time. Both these are same. So root mean square propagation, RMS prop, is similar to the solution of the first problem of EDAGRAD solved by Ada Delta. So the only difference in both the optimizers is that it needs a global learning rate and it does not. And the last one is the adaptive moment estimation, ADAM. So it was developed in 2014, and it is a combination of two types of optimizers. First one is the RMS or Ada Delta, both are quite same. And the previous one, previous from the EDAGRAD one, the stochastic gradient descent with momentum. So how it combines, it stores the exponentially decaying average of past squared gradients as we have seen earlier. And that is similar to both these optimizers. And it also stores the exponentially decaying average of past gradients, not past squared, past gradients. So this is a combination. So it solves all the problems basically. So these were my optimizers. Next, the deep models, what I have used here. So in deep models, I have selected two models from literature, and I have selected them because they have won an object recognition challenge that is very famous in different years. And that is a a model has to efficiently recognize the objects in an ImageNet data set. That is the biggest data set of object recognition with millions of classes and images. So in 2016, Inception V3 won this, and in 2017, Inception ResNet V2 won this. So you can see Inception ResNet V2 is slightly better than Inception V3 in the top one loss and in top five loss. But it has much more layers, 164 and 48, and so the size. So because there are many works where the gap between both performances is less. So we want to make sure, like, how much this both these models have difference in between on our data set. And so we will conclude it later. And also, I have used pre-trained models on the ImageNet data set. So I am using here basically a kind of transfer learning technique. So transfer learning technique is the weights of the model that is already trained will be transferred to the another data set prediction. So moving on to the next slide. Now we have hyperparameters, optimizers, and deep models. Now the data set on which I have worked. So this is the data set that is developed by Ansari and Harith in 2016. And these people are from Indian Institute of Technology, Jodhpur, Rajasthan, that is in India. So the original data set, here are the details. First, this is an Indian sign language data set. Then it is static only. It is single-handed and double-handed. It includes both. It has 140 Indian sign classes. 18 users have enacted these signs, and they performed each sign two times. And the equipment they have used is Microsoft Kinect camera to capture the data set. And these are the two data they recorded, RGB images and the depth images. So as my work is dealing with the comparative evaluation of the optimizers and the models, so I have taken 33 Indian signs out of 140. And I have split it into two parts. One is numerals and the second one is alphabets. So alphabets are normally more complex than numerals. So I have like both types of data set on which I can try my models. So numerals are 9 and alphabets are 24 because we have not used the alphabets which involve motion. And I have used only depth data, not the boat data. So here is a sample RGB image, although I have used only depth image just to give an example. So this was the RGB image, and this is its depth image that has the distance from the camera, every pixel's distance from the camera. So I used depth thresholding for segmenting the hand region. So here you can see the binary image here, and I have converted into color images because deep learning models usually use color images. So this is the introduction of the data set that I have been using. Then the second slide, on this slide, see, this data set is very small, as every user, every signer, 18 signers have performed it only two times. So you can see here, numerals are of two, like total 269 images and 15 because the data set originally has 18 users who perform the Indian signs, but they have opened only 15 for research community. So that's why I use only 15. So to increase the size of these data sets, I applied data augmentation, and I have used four operators to data augment. First one is blurring, then rotation, then random noise, and vertical flip. And I increased the data set to this number, 90,269 in numerals and 24,716 images in 24, around 10,000 per class I have added. So now comes the proposed methodology. So proposed methodology has been divided into three parts. In the first part, we will find what is which is the best batch size out of this these numbers 8 to 128 range. In the second part, using the best batch size, we will find which is the best optimizer. And then in the final step, using the both best batch size and the optimizer, we will see which is the best model. So here, for step one, these are the range, and we are varying batch size and are fixing our optimizer and model. So we have selected Adam and Inception V3. Inception V3 because it is comparatively like smaller than Inception Resonant V2, and based on the matrix like loss and accuracy, we find out which is the best one. So this is batch size. Then the best batch size is used with Inception V3. Now these both are fixed, and we will vary the optimizers and we'll get the best optimizer. And then by fixing the optimizer and the batch size, we'll find the Inception V3 and Inception ResNet V2, which models work best. So one thing, I have divided my data set for training into 80-20 ratio. And for the step one and step two, I have used only numerals data set because that is smaller among the alphabets and numerals data set. And the last one of models comparison, I have used both the data sets. So its results. So the first step was batch size. So its results are here. So I have shown the two graphs here. The first graph is the validation loss evolution over 100 epochs. I have used 100 epochs. So here you can see the lowest one is the black one, that is the 8 batch size. And as the batch size is increasing, the loss is also increasing with it. So it is like by just seeing, we can know that it is working better than others. But there is one trade-off of speed in batch size. If the batch size is more, then it will take less size and less time. And if the batch size is less, it will take more time. But the priority here is to get, you know, better recognition accuracy. So we are preferring batch size 8 here. Now, the second step was for optimizers. So this table is showing the best optimizers. So first one is AdaGrad, AdaDelta, RMS Prop, and Adam. Out of these, Adam is giving the best result as the lowest loss. And then validation accuracy is 83.79. And the same thing, there is a trade-off that this Adam optimizer takes more time. But yeah, our preference is like same throughout the work, that accuracy should be high. So in the next part, the models, the final models, so there are numerals and alphabets, the results for both the data sets. And here Inception ResNet V2 is getting higher accuracy. It is tiny slower than the Inception V3, but accuracy is high. And the difference is much, like it's not a 1-2% difference, the difference is much on our data set. So here you can see the confusion matrices to like understand the how they are performing on the signs in the sign language term. So this is a confusion matrix for numerals data set, and for Inception V3, this is Inception ResNet V2. So here, this 1, 6, 2 are the numbering according to like what number they are representing, and 0, 1, 5, 2, 3, 7 is based on this confusion matrices. So in this matrices, like you can see here, this is 1 and this is 6, representing 1 number and 6, and both have single finger. So they are confusing much. And these have a 1 finger difference. These are also confused by Inception V3. And these are quite same, like only a finger is like mold here. in the ninth. So these are confusing. So inception V3 is confusing much. And as you can see, the confusion has like drastically improved here. Similarly, for alphabets, there is visually, we can see too much confusion is going on, but here it is not. And so these are the signs which are very much confused, like P and Q. They are these are very much similar. Then M, N, S, T. So it is like, so these are some that I'm showing. Like there are many confusions going on here, but it has improved much. And if I compare it with literature, so these two papers are on this data set, and their accuracies are here. And first of all, this asterisk sign is because the work done by Raghuveera et al. In 2020, they have shown the accuracies for only 18 alphabets. So I have shown both the accuracies to compare with this paper. These are 18 alphabets and these are 24. So inception BraceletV2 is of course better than everybody, but the main observation is here that inception V3, even though it is a deep model and we have tuned it and optimizers are good, still it is giving, you know, less accuracy than the works on alphabets, like the two people before, and they both have used machine learning techniques and the handcrafted features. Still, like it is not performing that good. So like this is a takeaway that I will be, while concluding, I will be saying. So these are the conclusions. So for static ISL recognition, these are our conclusions. So first conclusion is inception BraceletV2, it has achieved like 10.6% and 14.56% more accuracy than inception V3 on numerals and alphabets. And this is very huge difference. Then inception V3 is giving even less accuracy, like even around 8% accuracy, less than the work people have done using machine learning. So even if the resources are not that great, if I have decent GPU, inception V3 might not work that great on static ISL. And the last two conclusions are that small batch size are giving better accuracy than the large here, and ADAM is performing, outperforming all the gradient based optimizers. So these are the conclusions from my work. And yeah, these are the references.
Thank you very much. Any question? We have time for one question. Question for the speaker? I have a question. With respect to batch size for training, what value gives the best for performance?
Sorry?
With respect to batch size for training, the batch?
Yeah.
Size, okay, wait, what's the best value?
This is 8.
8? Lower, yeah, okay. Lower. Thank you very much. Any question? No, thank you very much, Prachi.
I have one question. I had the same experience regarding the batch size and ADAM optimizer in a different application. And my question is, have you tried to improve your results using transfer learning, like fine tuning or tune your networks?
This is kind of a, you know, I have, actually, this is a fine tuning, but not that fine because I have just removed the top layer. But yeah, I have not done the too much fine tuning because according to literature, inception BraceletV2 is actually slightly better than inception V3 always. But I just wanted to know the gap in between. So yeah, I have not moved on to that part and just concluded from here.
Okay, thank you.